What's up, Felix Lehr here for Thomann Synthesizers, and today I'm playing David Against Goliath. The two contesters are the Korg Volca Beats, which will set you back a mere 100 to 150 bucks, versus the Analog Rhythm MK2 by Electron, which sits at a steep 1.6k. Alright, exactly how much more drum machine can you get for 10 times the money? Let's find out. Alright, let's get into it. First of all, why on earth would I even want to compare these two, since they are clearly in a different league? Well, because the Analog Rhythm is actually maybe my favorite drum machine, but I recently got myself this Korg Volca Beats and I was pleasantly surprised to such a degree that I wanted to make a video about it. And this seemed like a fun opportunity. Maybe let's start with the Korg Volca. Here's a little beat. Let's maybe delete the pattern first and see what we actually have here. It's fairly straightforward because pretty much everything you see is what you get. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 analog sounds and 1, 2, 3, 4 samples, which are preloaded audio files, I guess. And these six here are where it gets really interesting, and this is also what I primarily use. Let's start with the kick drum. You can control the attack, the pitch, and the decay. And as you might notice, this is actually not a toy-like sound. This thing could make a room shake really beautifully. All right, up next, the snare drum. This might be the most hated sound in electronic music as far as the internet is concerned, because of this crunch up here. But I actually think it sounds kind of lovely. If you want to see someone push this to the limit, I urge you to check out the track called Kuiper by Floating Points, where these two sounds are basically the main theme of the whole track, and it's an insane track. Anyways, up next, the tom section. We have actually a low tom and a high tom, and they are both in the same column here. You can change the pitch individually of the low and high tom, but the decay is shared between the two. And the same goes for the hi-hats actually, but vice versa. This here is the decay that you can control individually and the pitch that is shared between the two. And for the samples here, the controls are even more limited. You actually, just depending on which one you selected, you have this one knob here, which just controls the pitch of the sample, no decay whatsoever. And yeah, apart from that, maybe let's create a sequence real quick, because obviously we have a step sequencer here. Let's start with the kick. Now moving on to the snare, as indicated here by this light. This indicates which track we are selecting. Now maybe a tom. And a high tom. And now the hi-hat. Closed one first. And as usual with these drum machines, the closed hi-hat is actually being closed, the open hi-hat is actually being closed by the closed hi-hat. See the open hi-hat here being open as long as there's a closed hi-hat. And additionally, we have this stutter effect here, which sounds like a delay. But actually what it does is, I think, it just triggers the actual sound again and again really fast, because there's no actual delay effect built into it. It's just that the notes are repeated very, very quickly in a rhythmical fashion. And this can be utilized for some interesting glitches. IDM kind of effects. Alright, apart from that, you can control the volume of the individual sounds with this knob, depending on which sound is selected here. So, for example, let's turn down the hi-hat, the closed hi-hat, and now slowly bring it in. However, this thing doesn't have velocity sensitivity, unfortunately, and it also only has a 16-step sequencer. But where I think this thing really starts to shine is when you sequence it externally and apply some effects on it, like a subtle delay and distortion especially. So at the end of this video, I have a little jam for you where I demonstrate exactly that. But now let's move on to the Analog Rhythm MK2. I actually personally used MK1, but for the purpose of this video, I thought this looked a bit fancier. So let's maybe check out some patterns that I already created here. And as you can see, it already starts getting a whole lot more complex. What do we have here? Let's check out the individual sounds. First of all, we have a kick here, which is, of course, analog. And we also have analog filters built into this. And the neat thing about this is that, of course, as you can see here indicated by the screen, everything here is actually controlled digitally. So we have the power and the warmth and the beautiful imperfection of analog circuitry, but it's all controlled digitally, giving us the best of both worlds. So we have the ease of use and the precision of the digital world and the sound of the analog world. So basically everything one could wish for. As you can see, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 channels, to each of which you can load either a machine, which is essentially an analog sound source, like in this case here, it's one sort of kick drum, but we can load a different machine. And depending on which channel you are on, you have a slightly different selection of possible machines. For example, up here, we have more of the hi-hat kind of sounds. Exactly. And what's even more powerful about this thing is that on each of these channels, you can have an additional sampler unit. So you could turn on the synth, or you could turn it off and turn on instead the sampler. Yeah, some kick samples, for example. Oh no, wrong. Exactly. So this is now a sample that's loaded on here, but we can also actually use both at the same time and layer them. So this is just a sample, this is just the analog kick, and this is both layered together. And where this gets extremely powerful is, of course, when you import your own samples. Right now these are still just the factory sounds here. But let's see if they still have this noise sound, which I liked so much. Yeah. So now we have analog power and sampling character. And what I personally do is I import like 100 noise sounds that I created myself, and then instantly this whole thing is personalized to your own sound and to your own textures and qualities like that. Yeah, anyways, each of these channels has a reverb, a delay, compressor, one LFO, unfortunately just one. I could maybe use some more, but it's enough to work with. And where it gets really, really powerful is the sequencer. So maybe let's go ahead and create an entire new pattern here. So starting with the kick drum, let's turn the sample off again. First of all, obviously we can create a whole lot more than just 16 steps as with the Korg-Volker. But for now, let's keep it at that. And where Electron really starts to shine and unfold its full potential is their step sequencer, because I can actually manipulate every single step. For example, this kick drum I could filter a bit differently. Now this one is filtered a bit differently. I can move it a slight bit so that it's lagging a bit for more of a J. Dilla kind of groove. Then here, I could add a fill and give this fill a probability. So now the chance every time is 50% that the step will occur, as you see. It's like rolling a dice. So it's not every second time, but it's 50% chance. Yeah. But if I wanted more control, I could of course also tell it to just play on the second of two bars. And for this one, I could tell it to play on the third of every fourth bar. Yeah, and as you can imagine, this is super powerful, because even within a 16 step pattern, you could create endless variation, especially considering the fact that you can even control the duration of the pattern per track. So you could tell this one to be 6 bar long, and this one to be 7, and this one to be 12, or steps, not bars. And then you could, for example, create generative music that changes indefinitely for hundreds of years, slightly, yeah, with like 12 polymeters running over each other. And then obviously, I don't even think I have to mention that, this thing is in fact velocity sensitive. So for example, let's now add this hi-hat pattern here. So right now I already have an LFO running that is assigned to the panning of the sound, which you will notice if you're wearing headphones, which already creates some subtle movement here. And here you see the volume. And as I said, it's velocity sensitive, but not only that. We can control the volume of each step and put in some accents here. But we can actually control each parameter of all of these pages here completely independently for every single step, like for example here the filter. And now I can add either a reverb or a delay or a mixture of both. And even independently from this reverb here, you can tell the delay to go through a reverb automatically. All right, now we're starting to get a vibe here, just from this hi-hat. All right, sounds interesting. This deep techno sort of kick drum. So now let's maybe add a low tom to get the techno vibe going here. Aha, beautiful. And now to this one. I could also add some modulation. So maybe let me select the frequency. And modulate it subtly. And now this parameter here is being modulated by the LFO. And up next. One of my absolute favorite machines, which has been added actually with a software update. That's one of the great things about Electron, is that they keep doing software updates for ages, adding beautiful new features. Like this dual voltage controlled oscillator, which is essentially a complete synth engine. So you could already before, for example, utilize the low tom to create synth-like sounds, as you heard before here. But since they added this dual VCO, I think this thing is powerful enough to create complete tracks from scratch without any additional hardware. Obviously, it's a bit limiting, but considering this is a drum machine, it's actually insane. So maybe let's just add this synth here. And give this one a different pattern range. And start modulating it. Oh, it's already modulated. Beautiful. Yeah, and one other neat little feature is that actually there's an overdrive circuit, an analog overdrive circuit that you can send all of these channels through. So for example, let's do it with the synth here, or let's do it with the kick. It's a more beautiful demo. And you can even control if the distortion happens pre or post reverb and delay. So yeah, there's loads of stuff that you can explore on this thing for years. But why do I still love the Korg Volca? Let's conclude. Obviously, the Analog Rhythm MK2 is in a whole different league than the Korg Volca Beats. But what you get from the Korg Volca Beats is a super charming, characteristic drum rack that sounds like it sounds, like for example with the 808, 909, etc. This is what we expect from these machines. They have a certain sound, and if we want that sound in our music, we go for them. And that's exactly what the Korg Volca Beats offers, in my opinion. It's a really charming, warm analog kit, which I like to use in my music for the past couple of weeks, and I think it's gonna have a permanent spot here in my studio. The Analog Rhythm, on the other hand, doesn't really have a characteristic sound, because it could sound any way you like, because there's so much potential. You will never hear a record and say, oh, that's an Analog Rhythm, because if you really use its full potential, it sounds exactly how you want it to sound. And while it would be a challenge, it's totally possible to create completely fleshed out tracks of a very high level of sophistication just with an Analog Rhythm. So two very different machines for very different needs, but nonetheless, both of them are very lovely. Anyways, thanks for tuning in. If you have any more questions, feel free to let me know in the comments, and I'll try to answer every single one of them. Apart from that, see you next time. Peace out.